Hi everyone, this is Angela again. It's the 30th of December 2008, and so we need to wait a little bit longer. We're going to start a new year, 2009. I wanted to dedicate this little video to my doctor, Dr. Grinberg from Johns Hopkins. And I want to do this before the end of the year simply because from January 1st, 2009, Dr. Grinberg will not be working for Johns Hopkins anymore. And he's going to be actually working in Dallas, in Texas. He's actually from there. He's from Houston. So he's sort of going back home in a sense. But he also has a very important job to do at the Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas, University of Dallas. I hope I said that everything right. He's going to be there from the first of the year. And he has an important job to do. Why is that? Because he's going to be opening a second TM center, transesmolytic center. We only have one, only one in the world, and it's actually at Johns Hopkins. And now, thanks to him, we're going to have one in Texas. And he's also, after opening the center, he's going to become the director of the MS Center at the Southwestern Medical Center. So he has a really big job to do, and I'm very proud of him. And I wish him the best. And the reason why I decided to create this video, even if I don't feel too good today, was really to be able to create this and to talk about him and to let all of you know about this. So while I'm gonna miss him tremendously, and I think it's going to be, you know, it's gonna be sad not to have him as my doctor anymore. Like with everything, you receive sort of mixed news and you feel kind of sad about something. I'm also very happy for him, and I'm also very happy because I'm gonna be having another amazing doctor at Johns Hopkins. So I definitely find always something positive in everything that might be in the things that might not be as happy. I know he's gonna be incredible there, just as incredible as it was at Johns Hopkins. He took care of me in the right way. He was really always listening to me. He really cared, and that's what I think is so important to find in a doctor. And I hear a lot of people complaining about their own doctors because they don't feel that they are understood and they don't feel that they can really talk to their doctors. Well, I was lucky enough that I was able to do so. And while I do live 4.5 hours away from Johns Hopkins, so it's not like I was there, you know, very often, I do have to say that he always kept in touch by email, and so I was able to ask him all the questions possible and to tell him my concern, to share my concerns with him. And he would answer me at any time, at all times of the days and all times of the hours. And I'm learning that every single person who knows him have so many wonderful things to say about him. And I'm really definitely one of them. Like I said, he does treat you, and this is a big deal for me, and you probably heard it in many of my other videos, he didn't treat me like a patient. I was really like somebody that he cared about. It's really important. We're going through so much already. You don't want to feel like the doctor is distant from you and it's so cold toward you. And he's definitely not. He looks it in your eyes for the whole speech, for the whole time he talks to you, and that makes you feel very comfortable. And he explains everything and anything, and so you do end up feeling more comfortable about the disease, about the future. So I'm very thankful that I got to be his patient. I'm very grateful that I got to meet him. And well, he's also gonna be pretty incredible because he decided to put a link onto the website of the Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas to my own website. I don't know if you ever went to the Johns Hopkins website, but on two different pages, the neurological area where there is that, you know, all the doctors that work at the MS Center, TM Center, pretty much there are two pages where you can find my project, Flowers for MS, and there is the symbol of it, and if you press on it, you get to go directly to my website. And so he said that he's going to try to do the same and put a link to my website on the Southwestern Medical Center's website. And I thought that was really, really wonderful. And I'm learning so much, really. I mean, I've been sick only for 2 years, so I'm still new at this, but I'm getting really the feel that the MS community or the TM community is so close to each other. And it's so, I think everybody in the world wants to find a cure for these diseases. And while the institutions, you know, want to have the merit, they want to get their credit on, you know, a new discoveries and new medicines or whatever, you know, new studies. At the same time, they all work for the same thing. And so they don't mind sharing information. So, I mean, this is at least the feel that I'm getting. And so I do believe that, I know for a fact that Johns Hopkins and the Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas will be working very closely with each other. And so I know that they're going to do a lot of studies together. So I am possibly planning to while I continue to raise funds, of course, for the centers and for Project Restore at Johns Hopkins, I'm also planning to help Dr. Grinberg, because I feel very, very grateful. I feel very comfortable with him. I know that he loves what he's doing. I know that he's going to have amazing, you know, it's going to be just as incredible with the patients there in Dallas and from that side of the country too. And so I do believe that it's important to help him. So I would like to say that, and also he did an amazing gift to me, because he really helped me get another very good doctor. Dr. Calabresi will be my next doctor. He is the director of the MS Center at Johns Hopkins, and it was very hard for me to get an appointment with him when I was sick, because he's really working all the time on research, which I truly appreciate that. But he was the person that inspired me to choose Johns Hopkins as the institution to raise money for, to raise funds for, and to help. And so I never got to meet him. So I've been sick for 2 years, and I've been waiting for 2 years to finally meet him. And thanks to Dr. Grinberg, I will be able to one day at the end of March. So like I said, some things happen in your life that you don't understand right away the meaning for, but I had to meet Dr. Grinberg, I really did, because I was able to actually meet somebody that is wonderful, that is really caring, and through him, I'm getting to meet Dr. Calabresi, and I actually, thanks to him, I met Dr. Kerr, which was also very special to me. So I have to, you know, talk to all of you about him, because I've been very lucky. I've been very lucky to meet him. And so if any of you get sick, I hope not, or if you're already sick and you want to go to the to see Dr. Grinberg while you have him closer to you in Texas or all the part of the country, and I will suggest you to do so, because, like I said, you will definitely like to be in his care. So Dr. Grinberg, congratulations, good wishes, best wishes. I'm sure you're going to do fine. And you're going to help a lot more people. I really appreciate everything you've done for me, and I wish you the best for 2009 and for your future. And I would like to also wish all of you a good year. I hope you're going to be able to be happy. You're going to have good health, and happy. Happy is the secret. So I really hope, I wish you all the best. And hopefully next time I'll have more news to give you and share more things with you. And thank you for listening. Bye.